Imagine that a robot wants to go from a point start to a point end. But it can't go straight because there is a polygon obstacle that it wants to avoid. The robot wants to avoid the obstacle, but still wants to take the shortest path to reach end, so it wouldn't go like this, for example. In this example, here is the shortest path to go from start to end while avoiding the obstacle. But how did we find it? For that, we will use the concept we've been studying during the last two videos, the convex hull. Quick reminder, the convex hull of a set of points is the smallest convex polygon that contains all the points inside it. Convex polygon means that all interior angles are less than or equal to 180 degrees. To know how to compute it, you can watch one of the two previous videos where we cover two convex hull algorithms. First of all, we need to understand the property of convex hulls. That property says that the convex hull is the polygon that surrounds all the points with the smallest perimeter. This is why, for example, if we want to surround a set of trees by minimizing the length of fence used, we calculate the convex hull. It's the polygon that can surround all the trees by using as less fence as possible. So, if we modify any edge without breaking the property, even to the inside of the polygon, we get a longer perimeter. Which means that if we want to go between two points that are on the border without entering the polygon, we can just keep walking on the perimeter of the convex hull. For example, here we want to go between these points A and B. Here is the convex hull of the set of points. The shortest path is by walking on the perimeter, so it's either this path or this one. To know which one of them do we take, we just calculate the length of each one of them and compare. The length is the sum of the distance between each two successive points. And this is the strategy we will use for our initial problem. We have two points start and end, and a set of points that represents the obstacle. What do we do is that we compute the convex hull of the set of all the points, including start and end. After getting the convex hull, we split it into two paths, the clockwise path between start and end, and the counterclockwise one. Last step, we just calculate the total length and take the shortest one. In this example, we get a length of 1050.1 for path 1, and a length of 965.38 for path 2, which is smaller. This is why we take path 2. And we solve the problem of searching for the shortest path that avoids the obstacle. Note that in this problem, we assume that start and end are always a part of the convex hull. Here are some other examples. In code, we first create the set of points, which is made of the obstacle plus start and end. Then, we compute the convex hull, with the function we made in the previous video. Now, we need to split the hull into two paths. For that, we create two arrays, path 1 and path 2. The idea is that we will start from the position of the point start in the hull, then we keep adding hull points until we reach the end point. We write, while hull of I isn't equal to end, we add hull of I to the path 1, and we move to the next point in the hull. To move to the next point, we increment I, but we set it modulus the length of the hull to go back to the beginning when we reach the last point. After the loop, we add endpoint to the path. Now we found path 1, but we still need to traverse the second part to make path 2. We're actually at the endpoint and we keep walking until we reach start again, so while hull of I isn't equal to start, we add hull of I to path 2 and we move to the next point. After the loop, we add the last point of path 2, start. Now that we have both paths, we return the minimum, where the comparison key is the total length of each path. Total length function is just a function that calculates the sum of distances between each two consecutive points in a path. And we solve the problem. You can find this code in the description, plus the code that generates a random obstacle and plus the shortest path. For the time complexity, we have O of n log n for computing the convex hull, and O of n to compute path 1 and path 2 and compare their lengths, where n is the number of points of the obstacle. We get an O of n log n time complexity. And a space complexity of O of n because the length of the set of points is n plus 2. We've reached the end of this video, we've seen a cool application of convex hulls, which falls under the problem of motion planning. As usual, if you enjoyed, let me know by liking the video and commenting below. You can also recommend me subjects that you want me to talk about. See you in the next one.